بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اتبع هداه، أما بعد، الحمد لله. continuing our lesson within book 3, we spoke last time about the adat al-shart, fi'l al-shart, and jawab al-shart. We also noticed some new words or some rules. We noticed that the letter fa appears before the jawab in some cases. We saw also a couple of other new rules or new words. For example, kutayyibat. Khamsatu kutayyibatin mufidatin. And we didn't speak much about that. We just asked the meaning. And one of the brothers told us that it means small books. And we will come to this, inshallah, in a moment. We also said that this word is new, ha'um, i'lanan muhimman, which means here is. So before we go into the lesson, continuing to talk about shart or jawab al-shart and the different examples about that, let's look at these two things here. One is kutayyibat. One is ha'um. So go down to the lesson, to the tamarin, the exercises. Now, so here's one. Ha i'lana. He said ha hada ismu fi'lin, ha, just ha. Ism fi'l, it's the noun which has the meaning of a verb, and it's usually mabni, and it has the meaning of the verb. In this case, the meaning of ha is khudh, which means to take. As you said, ha al, this is an example, ha al kitaba ya aliyu. Ha il kitaba ya aminatu. جمع هاؤم، هاؤم الكتاب، mean take, take this book يا إخوة، تو أن هاؤن الكتاب يا أخوات. And in سورة الحاقة الله تعالى said فيقول ها أمقرأ كتابية، ها أمقرأ كتابية، ها أم، take and read your book. Or my, عفوا, and he will say rejoicing, the person that was given his book in his right hand. فأما من أوتي كتابه بيمينه فيقول هاؤم اقرءوا كتابيه إني ظننت أني ملاقيه. Is that right? Oh, forgive me. نعم. فيقول هاؤم اقرءوا كتابيه إني ظننت أني ملاقي حسابيه. فهو في عيشة راضية. Okay. So that's the ayah. That's no problem, Abu Maymun. Stay safe. Stay on the left or the right. طيب. That is ha'um. Finished. And the other one is kutayyibun. Kutayyib is تصغير. Which means to show something or talk about something like it's a small form, a small form of something. Now, we studied it before when there were only three letters. So for example, waladun becomes wulaydun. Okay, maybe that's not a good example because it's hardly used because walad is already صغير. But you have another good example. عمرو عمير عمير. Yes, أحسنت أخي عمران. حسن حسين. رجل رجيل. عبد عبيد. So the pattern that's being followed is for three letter words, فعيل فعيل فعيل. This is what brings the word into the I'm not sure of the actual term in English, into a small form.
Diminutive, I think.
Naam, akhi, that's what I was thinking. I was that way. I was reluctant to say it. Neither does it make much sense if we say it. It's like diminutive form, okay? What does it? We have to now explain diminutive form to mean the same thing to the small form or something. It's not like, it's not everyday language, is it?
Ay, naam.
Another example, Jabalun, Jabalun, Jubailun. Okay. So this is when the letter, when the word has three letters. Umar, Hassan, Rajul, Abd. But if the word has three letters, Afwan, if the word has four letters, then the pattern changes. And here I can see that they've given the patterns over here. Let's have a look at them. So the tasghir has three patterns. The first is fu'ail. For example, the ones that we just gave. And Nujaym from Najm. Jubail from Jabal. Ubaid from Abd. The second pattern is fu'ail. Fu'ail. That's when the original word has four letters. For example, فندق. So the first letter, this is the fa al-kalima. The second letter, this is the عين الكلمة الأولى. The third letter, this is عين الكلمة الثانية. And then the last one you have, لام الكلمة. In between them will appear a ya. And it will become فنيدق. Same for the word درهم. It will become دريهم. And same for the word كتاب. It will become كتيب. Okay. Supposing the word has five letters, like for example, the word مفتاح. مفتاح. The ميم is the fa of the kalima. The fa is the عين of the kalima. The ta is another عين of the kalima. And the ha, this is the lam of the kalima. And the fifth letter is this alif. This gets converted into a ya, and another ya will be added after the first ayn, and it becomes fu'ay'il. Fu'ay'il. An example of that is miftah mufaytih. Finjan, funayjin, and dinar, dunaynir. Okay, here we have a number of examples. 9 examples. Some of them are 3 letters, some of them are 4 letters, some of them are 5 letters. So we got Imran and we have Ahmed bin Hussein. If you could take it in turns, and the sisters, if you could type your answers, inshallah, for turning these words into التصغير.
عفوا استاذ، this time I'll be driving to work, so I'm listening to the Bluetooth. Sorry about that, استاذ. I'm
لا
driving.
بأس، لا بأس، لا بأس أبدا.
يعطيك الخير استاذ.
So it looks like it's falling on your shoulders, Akhi Imran. Oh, Abdul Karim, Afwan, you're in the other, I didn't see you because you're in the other group. You're on my screen, you come into in the different section with the panelists. طيب, Akhi, between Imran and Abdul Karim, let's start with Abdul Karim. Waladun.
Waladun.
Waladun, Ahsant. Imran, Kindilun.
Kindilun. Kunaydilun.
Kunaydilun, na'am. To be honest, I'm not sure. Maybe somebody could remind me here. Are these words, the Ruba'i and Khumasi, are they, or the Khumasi, is the Khumasi mamnu' min al-sarf? Not the Ruba'i, the Khumasi.
La adri.
Tayyib. So let's say it without the i'rab at the end, just to be safe, and we'll, as they say, sakin taslam. Put a sukun and you'll be safe. So as you said, ahsant, qunaydil. Tayyib, Abdul Karim.
Ghulamun.
This is 4 letters, like kitab.
Yeah, kitab. This will be Ulay قليل من قليل
يا لهو
قليل من قليل من
أحسنت أحسنت بارك الله فيك. غليمون
قليل قليل من
غليمون.
عصفور قصيفير
بارك الله فيك أحسنت. قريب
طعام طعام البيت أي من
عفوا
أي من يعني
أحسنت
أي من أي من
أحسنت. تعيمون
تعيمن
تعيمون أحسنت أخي تفضل.
تعيمن
قريب
قريب قريب
قريب هذا كريم. جعفر
جعفر جؤي جؤيفر
أحسنت. جعيفر
حمار حمير حمير
نعم حمير بارك الله فيك.
سرير سري سرير سريري سرير
سرير أحسنت.
سرير
maybe you might call a baby's cot سرير. It's a small bed. طيب الحمد لله. Now we can go back to the main text. So in the main text, what was happening was the muraqib had walked in. The muraqib, like he's the floor supervisor. Yeah, he's not a teacher, he's an admin staff, and he stays outside of the classrooms to, you know, support and to administer things that are going on. He said he came in with that student and Nu'man, who was late. La la afwan. He came in with the five books, small books. He said, Ha'um i'lanan muhimman. Here is an important notice or notification. These are five small beneficial books that contain Islamic stories. Whoever reads them and answers the questions at the end will have a prize. And whoever wants to register for the exam, he said, فَمَنْ أَرَادَ أَنْ يَشْتَرِكَ. To yashtarika means to participate, to join. يشترك في هذه المسابقة in this competition. فَ this is the جواب الشرط. ميم is the أداة الشرط. أرادة is the فعل الشرط. فَ is the beginning of the جواب الشرط. فَلْيُسَجِّلْ. So he gives أمر. He should register اسمه عندي. Register his name with me. Then Ibrahim says, so I need an Ibrahim and I need a Muraqib and a teacher. So there's two readers, Abdul Karim and Imran. Father Akhi Abdul Karim.
Ya Sheikh, la najidka fi maktabika fi kathirin min al ahyani.
طيب read this again please.
لا نجدك.
Why did you put a sukun on the dal? You're reading it like it's la and nahya. Like he's they're forbidding themselves to find him. Is that what's happening?
No, is it لا نجدك؟
بارك الله فيك أحسنتم. لا نجدك في مكتبك في كثير من الأحيان. Now we have a word here which looks like, I'm not sure, but it seems it may be the first time it's introduced, because in الكتاب الأول الدرس الأول you have هذا مكتب. And what is it in English? You remember? Very
مكتبة
good,
أوفيس
Hassan.
أوفيس
أوفيس
Desk, now.
ديسك
Here, they said, يا شيخ, لا نجدك في مكتبك في كثير من الأحيان. Does it mean we don't find you in your desk
in your head.
very often? In actual fact, another meaning of maktab, as some of the sisters have said, is office. Office. So maktab also means office. And we mustn't confuse maktab, maktabun, office, with maktabatun, with the tamarbuta, which means library, or maybe even a stationer shop, stationery shop in some places. Okay, so they're complaining, we can't find you in your office. Muraqib responds, Imran.
إن لم تجدوني في مكتبي فستجدونني في مكتب المدير. يا فضيلة الشيخ، إن عبد الله،
What?
يا فضيلة الشيخ، فضيلة،
What's that
عفوا،
sound?
يا فضيلة الش... يا فضيلة الشيخ، نعم، يا
Here,
فضيلة الشيخ،
hold on. You're muffling the sound when it comes to the tamarbuta. I'm not sure if it's
فتحة مفتوح.
intended. You are doing what they say, what they call ishmam, which is a sound between two sounds.
بارك الله فيك.
يا فضيلة الشيخ.
نعم. يا فضيلة الشيخ، إن عبد الله
So
في
you know what
مكتبي.
you're saying? You're saying يا فضيلة تش 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 تي like that تش شيخ. No, there's a fatha here and it's intended. So you'll say يا فضيلة يا فضيلة الشيخ, not تش شيخ. You see, can you hear the difference? And
Could you say it again one more time?
يا فضيلة الشيخ.
أيوة. يا فضيلة الشيخ،
أحسنت.
إن عبد الله في مكتبي. إن اعتذر إليك أفتسمح له بالدخول؟
أحسنت. So over here, there are two things happening. The first thing is he responds to those students and says, in. What is in?
من أداة الشرط.
أداة الشرط. لم تجدوني. This is
فعل الشرط.
فعل الشرط. And هو في اسم مجزوم باللم.
نعم.
But لم تجدوني في مكتبي, all of that جملة could be, or لم تجدوني is في is مجزوم في محل جزم فعل الشرط. Okay, then he said the جواب الشرط فستجدونني ستجدون تجدونني ستجدونني سين of مستقبل, and then the far before it جواب الشرط فستجدونني في مكتب المدير. You find me in the dean's office or the principal's office. Then he turns back to the teacher and addresses him and says, يا فضيلة الشيخ, إن, how do you know this is not in?
سياق.
السياق, which is the context. And because there's no فعل after it, it's اسم. So, إن عبد الله في مكتبي. طلع is in my office. إن اعتذر إليك, this is the شرط. أداة الشرط. And فعل الشرط. This is فعل ماضي. اعتذر means excuses himself. He presents an excuse or he says sorry. اعتذر. يعتذر. If you want to say, I am sorry, you say to somebody, أنا أعتذر. But notice after it, you don't say معك or فيك or عليك. You say إليك. You can say to somebody, if you're sorry, you want to apologize to them, you say, أنا أعتذر إليك. So he's using فعل ماضي. إن اعتذر إليك أفتسمح له. So this is the جواب of the شرط. أفتسمح له بالدخول. تسمح, which means to allow. So if he was to seek, if he was to apologize, would you allow him to come in? The mudarris said,
نعم.
Ahsant. Okay, made you wait all that time just for one line. Actually, you have another line coming.
Yeah.
Then the muraqib leaves, and then the teacher says,
Ya Ahmadu, ikhra al-ayat al-waridata.
Afwan?
Ikhra al-ayata.
La.
اقرأ الآيات.
نعم اقرأ الآيات.
اقرأ الآيات. اقرأ الآيات الواردة في الدرس.
أحسنت. And الواردة means that which comes in. Read the ayah that comes in the درس. Go ahead, أخي Imran. Read Ahmed, please.
بعد الاستعادة والبسملة.
الاستعاذة أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. البسملة بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
نعم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا إن تنصروا الله ينصركم
عفوا.
إن تنصروا الله ينصركم و
ينصر ينصركم.
ينصركم نعم إن تنصروا الله ينصركم ويثبت أقدامكم.
أحسنت بارك الله فيك. So then Ibrahim asks, تفضل أخي.
أنا وعبد الكريم.
لا عبد الكريم.
لماذا جزمت الأفعال جزمت الأفعال أفعال الواردة في هذه الآيات يا فضيلة الشيخ؟
أحسنت. So he's asking about the المجزومات, الأفعال المجزومة. لماذا جزمت الأفعال الواردة؟ Where are the أفعال الواردة which are مجزومة here? How many are there?
تنصروا ينصركم.
So how many are there altogether?
There's one فعل, no? إن تنصروا الله. That's the فعل, and then ينصركم is the جواب.
No, no, he's asking about the مجزومة, about the question, how many are مجزوم?
1, 2, 3, 4.
Where's the fourth one?
أنا free.
Where are they?
تنصروا ينصركم and يثبت.
Then the teacher responds and gives the reason why. He says,
إن أداة شرط تجزم فعلين نحو إن تجتهد تنجح.
If you were to work hard, you will succeed. And he says,
إن تذهب إلى السوق أذهب معك.
Yes, if you go to the market, I'll go with you. طيب, then the teacher says,
ويسمى الأول فعل الشرط والآخر جواب الشرط والآخر جواب الشرط.
أحسنت.
وفي الآية الكريمة فعل الشرط تنصر وجوابه ينصر والفعل يثبت معطوف على ينصر.
أحسنت. Because he said, Allah Ta'ala said, ينصركم ويثبت. و that واو is واو العطف. واو here is واو العطف. So this يثبت is معطوف على ينصر. That's what's happening. أيوة ثاني سؤال.
أرجو أن تكونوا قد فهمتم.
نعم I hope you have all understood. طيب keep going.
أتستطيع أن تذكر آية آية
عفوا
أن تذكر
هكذا
عفوا
مرزوم.
لا عفوا أن تذكر آية أخرى.
مرفوع
أتستطيع أن تذكر أن تذكر عفوا عفوا إذ أن عفوا
أيوة
هذه
لكن
complete my
وصلنا
English for no reason. نعم أن
وصلنا
تذكر آية أخرى
أيه
آية أخرى
نعم
آية أخرى تحوي إن يا ياسر.
بارك الله فيك. So the teacher is asking for an ayah that contains in Yasir says
نعم بعون الله قال
with Allah's
تعالى
help. With Allah's help. بعون الله
بعون الله
with
قال
Allah's help.
تعالى قال تعالى وإن تعودوا نعود
وإن تعودوا نعد.
نعود.
أحسنت. Teacher says
أحسنت. أيمكنك أن تذكر آية أخرى يا نعمان؟
طيب النعمان said
نعم بعون الله قال تعالى وإلا تغفر لي وترحمني أكن من الخاسرين.
aha and the teacher says
ما شاء الله إلا هنا أصلها إن ولا النافية.
نعم بارك الله فيك. Look at this. وإلا which is actually وإن لا تغفر لي. This is مجزوم بأداة الشرط. وإلا تغفر لي وترحمني معطوف أكون. This is جواب الشرط من الخاسرين. جواب الشرط is from here. أكون is the جواب. بارك الله فيكم. طيب then he asked تفضل أخي.
أثمت عداوة أخرى
No عداوة. There's no alif after the dal.
أدوات
نعم أدوات هن.
أثمت أدوات أخرى
Why is there only one dhamma? He said أدوات. Is it one dhamma?
Yes, but why I'm not sure.
Doesn't have alif or lam, so it must be mudaf. Is it mudaf? No. So it's nakira. أثمت أدوات أخرى. Are there any other like words that will be used? تجزم فعلين يا
تجزم
أستاذ.
فعلين يا أستاذ.
نعم. That will make two verbs مجزوم. Teacher said.
نعم إن حرف وهناك عشرة أسماء تجزم فعلين أهمها
Okay,
من.
so he said, "Naam." To Ahmed's question, yes, there are other words that will create two majzoom fi'ls. The first one he said is "in," and this is "aywa hasantu." Thamma and thammata. This is means hunaka. It is, and Allah knows best. It is not mansub. It is. مبني. إن is a harf. And there are ashara asma that will create al-jazm upon fi'lain for two verbs. For example, man. For example, ma, mata, aina. All of these, they are not known as huruf. They're known as asma. Ay. Thammata, wallahu a'lam, is it means hunaka. Going back to the word thamma, as the sister asked, it means thamma, it means hunaka. And wallahu a'lam, it is majzu, it is mabniyun ala al fath. And it has the meaning of thamma and thammata. It's the same thing. Wallahu a'lam. Yes, it will be dharf. Yes, dharf or makan. Okay. And mahma. So he mentioned 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. He said there are 10, but the most important ones are these. Then he gave these examples. Read them, Aki, please.
من نحن نحو فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يره.
Where's the جواب الشرط؟
يره.
أحسنت. يره. يرى. يرى. And it is مجزوم ب how was the علامة الجزم؟
حذف واو.
حذف حرف العلة.
نعم نعم
حذف
حذف حرف العلة.
أحسنت. Which is the last one. يرى. Which is the ألف مكسورة. طيب keep going.
ما نحو وما تفعل من خير يعلمه الله.
No, there's no قلقلة on the ميم. If you do قلقلة on the ميم, it sounds like you gave it a فتحة.
نعم. وما تفعل من خير يعلمه الله.
نعم. And this ميم, you have to hold your tips, hold your lips closed tight. يعلمه الله.
نعم بارك الله فيكم.
Keep going.
متى نحو متى تسافر أسافر.
Now, whenever you travel, I'll travel.
أين نحو أين تسكن أسكن.
جيد.
وكثير نعم
أين wherever you stay, I will stay.
وكثيرا ما تلحقها ما
تلحقها
زائدة تلحقها ما الزائدة للتوكيد نحو أينما تكون يدرككم الموت.
أحسنت.
نعم.
Keep going.
أي نحو أي معجم نجد في
أي
المكتب
معجم
أي معجم نجد في المكتب مكتبة في المكتبة نشتريه.
And where is the جواب الشرط and what's the علامة الجزم؟
نشتري وعلامة جزم حذف حرف علة.
أحسنت. تفضل.
مهما نحو مهما تقول نصدق.
Whatever you say, we will believe. Then the teacher finishes by saying,
افهموا هذا الدرس جيدا فمن
افهموا
افهموا هذا الدرس جيدا
بس
فمن
السكون
عفوا أستاذ
الدرس like it's got a سكون on the scene.
أو عفوا افهموا هذا الدرس هذا الدرس جيدا.
Allahu Akbar. Does anyone want to jog Imran's memory?
درسة درسة
Aywa, you jogged it yourself.
نعم بارك الله فيك.
Why is معجم مجرور? Because A is مضاف. A will come as مضاف. That's why معجم is مجرور. The sister was asking. Keep going, أخي.
فمن فهم هذا الدرس فقد فهم دروسا كثيرة. لي درس إضافي هذا المساء، فمن أراد أن يستفيد فليحضر، ومن لم يحضر فليس بملوم.
Ahsan Jabarakallahu. We'll stop there. But if you just have a look at he said what he said at the end, he said, افهموا هذا الدرس جيدا فمن this man is شرطية فاهمة فعل الشرط فقد فاهمة جواب الشرط دروسا كثيرة. Then he said لي درس إضافي meaning of إضافي like
نعم.
مضاف مضاف إليه it means extra I have an extra class this evening هذا المساء هذا المساء فمن ف that is part of استئنافية من is أداة الشرط أراد is, جو, is فعل الشرط من أراد أن يستفيد فليحضر جواب الشرط and he said ومن أداة الشرط لم يحضر فعل الشرط فليس بملوم جواب الشرط ملوم means blameworthy Maloom means blameworthy. Where does that occur again in the ayah?
فلا تلوموني ولوموا أنفسكم.
That's true, that is one. فتولى عنهم فما أنت
بملوم.
بملوم. Which translates as so turn away from him for you are not to blame. Or from them for you are not to blame. Or he said So turn away from them. You are not blameworthy. Barakallahu feekum. We'll stop there, inshallah. Continue bi-idhnillah at this point. And for homework, there is plenty to get on with. Here is one you have to read. It says that there are 10 places where, or nine, where the jawab al-shart will begin with fa. Read them, please. And then, he said, la yujzamu jawab al-shart idha iqtarana bil fa. If the fa is in the jawab al-shart, then you don't make it majuzum. However, in the I'rab, it is fi mahalli jazm. Because it's in a jumla. So now what you have to do is, there are 20 sentences here. Choose any 10 sentences. This is the homework. Choose any 10 sentences. And add the fa to the jawab al-shart and mention the reason why you added fa. Your reasons are going to be here, these nine reasons. One, two, جملة اسمية، فعلا طلبيا، فعلا جامدا. Start with قد. Start with ما النافية. Start with لن. With seen. سوف. And starting with كأنما. So it will become فكأنما. This will become فسوف. This will become فسأسافر. فلن. فلن يلبس. فلن يلبسه في الآخرة. As comes in that hadith. Okay, we'll stop there. Inshallah, barakallahu fikum. جزاكم الله خيرا والله أعلم، وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.